valley unknowns. Oh, lift your voices. Lift your voices. Lift your voices. Lift your voices. Sing before the Lord. Raise your voices in tongues before the Lord. Raise your voices in strength. Raise your voices in power. Join with the power. Echo in the power. Lift your voices in power. Not as a weak voice, but as a strong voice. Because I have made you strong. I have made you strong. I took you through the battle, and I have made you strong. Raise your voice strong above the land, because your voice shall be strong above this land. And raise your voice strong, strong, strong. I have made you strong.
Christian soldiers.
Amen.
doing what God sent us to do.
Amen.
It is good.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jenny. That was beautiful. And praise and worship team, thank y'all. They still got a song in them. They still, after singing all, what, seven services? We mixed it up some, but seven services. We made it through. Hallelujah. Some of us made it through all seven services. I can't, y'all, not everybody gets an eight once. JT, what about Oxana? When's she coming home?
Well, we really can't tell now because her mom has been in the hospital for 5 days.
Oh, no.
And the numbers, you know, on some numbers dealing with her sugar diabetes is not cooperating with my prayers, right? And so the numbers was like six when she went in. And what that did to her is made her not know where she was and hallucinating and seeing all kinds of things and talking, you know, just out of her mind. And now they got the numbers down to two. But they can't let her out and say the numbers are zero. So with that being said, Oksana can't come home until her mom is, you know, in her right mind. And so we're going to have to send someone.
God sent her over there at the right time.
Yes, yes. And I just have to accept it.
Well, what's her mother's name?
Lula.
Lula?
Yeah.
Lord, we just pray for Oksana and Lula.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that Lula will be totally well, able to come to the United States strong.
Yes.
And Lord, I pray for Oksana to be able to manage this. We know she's a strong woman.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that she will be able, you will send angels to her to help manage this. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
While we were worshiping, Danae sent a word that Robert Ivert was asking for prayer. His legs are very wobbly, concerned that it was his heart. I sent a message back and asked him to come up and let's pray for him. Let's pray for him now. Lord, we pray for Robert Ivert's health. He has a young family and he can be able to raise this young family. Lord, so I pray for his heart to be well and strong in Jesus' name. And Miss Bates, you want to introduce your friend?
Miss Julie, I work with her at school transportation.
Okay, Miss Julie, we welcome you today. Okay, Faith, are you driving the school bus now? Or?
I'm a bus attendant.
And I'm a bus attendant also.
Bus attendant.
Bus attendant. Okay, and Miss Julie, do you drive the school bus?
I'm a bus attendant also.
Okay, we'll just bring all the bus drivers in, you know?
That's right.
But we're glad to have you. We have Joy in Henson visiting us today, and I guess the rest of you are supposed to be here. You're not visitors. Glory. Okay, a Josiah Company. Prophet Clay Nash said we were a Josiah Company. I thought it best that I pull out the Josiah scriptures and figure out just what it might mean for us. It has to be a good thing. Because 2 Kings 23:25 says, now before him, and that would be Josiah, there was no king like him who turned to the Lord with all his heart, with all his soul, and with all his might, according to the law of Moses. Nor after him did any arise like him. Nations must be governed by men who are governed by God.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. If we are to have the blessing of God, we have to be governed by men who are governed by God. The prosperity and blessing of a nation is based on that. The monarchical period of Israel's history began with the wrong motives and the choice of Saul. But see, the blessing was on Israel. See, God blessed Israel. God put his blessing on Israel. And so even though they chose a king, when God didn't want them to have a king, God still blessed Israel because his blessing was on Israel. And he expanded it by Saul's successor, David. know is the most glorious of Israel's kings. Of the wisdom and riches of his reign, only the half has been told. Following Solomon, there were only a few notable leaders among the kings of Judah. If you notice, when it says he was a bad king, he had a bad mother. He was a good king, he had a good mother. The blessing of a good mother brings forth a good man.
Yes.
These include Joash, Hezekiah, and Josiah, and all were northern kingdom kings. Most of the remainder of Judah's kings were conspicuously lacking in spiritual leadership. We have spiritual leadership in our nation now under our president. Mm-hmm. There are prophets all the time. The church is welcome in the White House again. Prophets, ministers go and pray for him, and prophets go and prophesy to the President of the United States.
Thank you.
As y'all know, I had a dream last week where I was seated in this big room of people, massive room of people. And a man was seated at the table, which was the President, but it wasn't Donald Trump, and I felt like it was the Lord. The Lord as President. He called my name out and he says, "Carolyn, go open the O file." We'll call it the O file. I think it was four letters. I'm sure it was in code now that I think about it, because I knew in the dream that it really didn't look like a word that we would know. I know there was a P in it, perhaps an E, perhaps an M. I can't be sure, but it was only four or five letters. And I go into this massive room that has miles of file cabinets. And it seems that I have filed every one of those files, and I'm horrified. I thought, what if I better go check that out? Don't tell them, I need to make sure all that stuff is right if I do that. But I go straight to the old file, and there it is. And that the word, before I left to go to the old file, a man came to his desk and said to him, "Mr. President, there is a crisis in Iran. It's an emergency. I need you to take care of it." This was probably Tuesday I had this dream, I think. Okay. So then I go get the O-file. But see, what he said to me was, "Carolyn, go get the O-file. It's time to open the file." So when I take the file back, and there were two sealed there was a few papers in the old file. It had a name, okay. And there's a reason why God's not showing you the name. And they were rolled like this, about that long, rolled up and sealed. So I take it back to his desk, and he has left to go attend to the Iranian crisis. And I lay the file on his desk, not knowing if I'm to open the seals of the file or to wait till he does. And the dream ended. So there is a file that the Lord spoke to me in the dream, an old file that is ready to be opened. OPMA, a code name. A derivative of words. It dreams, you have to figure, they're mysteries. The file is a mystery because God did not reveal it to me. Mysteries of God. So I'm praying into this. We prayed Wednesday night and some things came forth. I'll be praying with Sarah Ballinger's team tomorrow night. They have something, their intercessor from California has some, God showed her something about a file. Just wanted to tell you all about this. We're talking about kings who need spiritual leadership. Why did he tell me to go get the old file? It was time to open it. He didn't tell me to open it. He just told me to go get it. But then there was an international incident that caused a distraction. Mm-hmm. That's what I think. We've got to pray the Iranian situation. If my dream is prophetic, and it's pretty strong, If my dream is prophetic, the international incident that's going on with Iran not right now is a distraction to keep the president from opening the oak farm. Anyone get a witness on that? I just did.
Yes. And I believe, Carolyn, the O, the beginning, is alone. What follows after that will come when the file is open. We will know who else is involved.
That's good then. Yeah. Okay. We're talking here about prophetic leadership for presidents, for leaders of nations, for kings. Mm-hmm. And most notable, what the kings lacked in moral influence was made up by the great prophets. Okay, some of the spiritual church are very offended with President Trump. Because he doesn't have the same moral standards.
Correct.
Okay. Well, okay, church, this is your deal. You're the one, the prophet, the church. You're the one that's supposed to be covering him.
Yes.
He's chosen by God because he's a warrior. Mm-hmm. But you're supposed to be covering him. You're the prophets. You're the one that's supposed to be pushing back Iran.
Amen.
Just like we pushed back that storm during the conference. It didn't amount to anything. We're supposed to be pushing back Iran right now because according to my dream, it's a distraction because it is time to open the O file. Can we agree on that?
Yes.
In other words, what's really going on right now is not Iran. What's really going on is something that the Lord is going to do in this country. If my dream.
He's revealing. He's going
to
reveal.
You know, Satan can cause an international incident if he wants to. And we know that Obama is totally connected.
Yes.
With Iran.
Yes.
Still.
Yes.
Okay. Most notable among the prophets during the time of the kings was Elijah, Isaiah, and Jeremiah before the exile. Ezekiel and Daniel during the exile, Zechariah and Malachi after the exile. And as you know, we're studying the prophecies of Zechariah at our Tuesday morning Bible study. The primary prophets into the administration of Josiah were Jeremiah, Zephaniah, and Huldah the prophetess. The prosperity of the kingdom is based upon the prophetic word that flows in life and power from the throne of God. JT, you want to take care of that? They don't realize that we're in here talking and taping. We'll let JT take care of that. Thank you, JT. Okay, you see how that interference came just as I said that? Mm-hmm. The prosperity of the kingdom is based upon the prophetic word that flows in life and power from the throne of God. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The role of the prophet from the throne of God is absolutely necessary to the prosperity of a nation, person, or church. The kings were not moral, spiritual men over Israel, except for David. But God had prophets around them to go to them and say, thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Now, prophets have not had access to the White House for a very long time.
Right.
But they do now.
Thank you, Jesus.
For a long time, but they do now. The five periods of repentance and restoration among the kings of Judah, especially Hezekiah and Josiah, point to the present day of restoration. God's plan with the whole earth, it's not all these politics that's going on that you see on your televisions. which is so ridiculous. It's not even, it's, it has nothing to do with God.
Right.
And what God's doing on the earth. God's plan is restoration.
Amen.
God's plan is redemption.
Yes.
God's plan is to, is to tear a nation to God. Mm-hmm. I never know it. When Apostle Clay Nash, we want to extend to him and his family. Can you imagine?
Oh,
I saw pictures of one of his granddaughters. She must have been about 12 years old.
Oh,
and their, you know, young family, the father was just killed. Sunday morning, he was killed in a motorcycle crash. I can't even imagine that kind of pain for this family. And but we just need to pray. Lord, we pray right now. We honor Apostle Clay Nash, and we pray right now, Lord, for this family, for his children, and Lord, that you will carry them through this. In Jesus' name we pray. Anyway, last week at our conference, he said our church is a Josiah Company. I'm presenting this word to us, to our church, to apprehend that which the prophet activated by the spoken word. When a prophet comes into an assembly, their spoken word activates over us what God has ordered for that assembly.
Yes.
I know I'm a prophet, but I don't care at all. That's the reason why we bring in a diversity of ministries, and can you say diversity?
Yes.
Amen.
I think next week, is it next week we have Samuel's coming in? Emmanuel's coming in. We'll have a word. Okay, so I looked up the prophecy posted on the Elijah list. This is what Brother Clay wrote. On Saturday, August 25th, 2018, while listening to my friend Dutch Sheets speak on the fivefold ministry gifts and the working of a territorial ecclesia. I'm not sure what they mean by territorial ecclesia. I have to ask you about that. That means us taking a territory. We may have spiritually over territory, but I'm not looking to have any group of any apostle come to take over our church or to take over any small churches. That's what a lot of them are doing right now. Trying to take over these small churches and put them up under their apostolic hook. They're building an apostolic hook. So I don't know what that means, but that probably it doesn't mean that at all. Okay, I heard the Lord speak clearly. Yes, as I was focused on spiritual understanding being released, I heard the Spirit of the Lord say that next year, 2019, because he gave this prophecy in August 2018, he would release the 31-year reign of the Josiah Company. Yes, the Josiah Company. This is still his prophecy. I find it interesting that 31 years from next year brings us to 2050. I have been pressing in to get spiritual understanding of these words and heard Chuck Pierce mention the book he wrote back in 2001. Let me interject here. When we get words from the Lord, they're often mysteries, like my Ophon. You've got to press in to get the total meaning of what God is speaking to you. And it's in the pressing in that you bring it out of the spirit realm into the natural. That's part of our job in the prophetic ministry. And everyone in here, you may not know it, but every single one of you are called to be in the prophetic ministry.
Yes.
And you might as well put your shoulder to the plow and get the work done and figure this thing out, that it's not play in school. And it's not playing church.
That's right.
Amen. Okay, back to his prophecy. Chuck Pierce's book, Future War of the Church. I have that book, but I haven't read it. He spoke of how many people could not grasp the truth written in that book because it was for a future time. I believe that time is now. Even as Chuck said in his book, he devoted several pages to truth and spiritual understanding of who Josiah was during his time. The first thing I want to point out is that Josiah is recorded as being the most notable king of all times, and he reads again the scripture that I just read to you, 2 Kings 23:25. He says, as I reread the future of the war of the church, I found some insight on the attributes of Josiah that will be seen in this Josiah company. I must first say that 31 is the number of the Hebrew word El. Yes, it means God. Mm-hmm. Next, let's look at the kingdom attributes of this honorable king and how this Josiah company will operate in them. The next notes are taken from truth and spiritual understanding he's given from the book. Number one, Josiah honored the ways of his spiritual father, King David. This Josiah company will honor the ways of our founding father by honoring the King of Kings. I'm going to get to the scripture in a little bit, but 365 years before, let me just go to the end of the story here, tell you about the beginning. 365 years before, let's see if I can find it. Yeah. Josiah is one of the seven people in the Holy Bible. We'll just skip around here. Who were named before they were born. Josiah came to the throne at the age of 8, 325 years after the prophecy of 1 Kings 13:1-12. So the reason I brought this in here is because he came as the son of David. Says so in the prophecy, even though his father was a wicked king, Amon. He came as the son of David. 1 Kings 13:1-2. Behold, there came a man of God out of Judah by the word of the Lord unto Bethel and Jericho, stood by the altar to burn incense. And he cried against the altar in the word of the Lord and said, O altar, altar, thus saith the Lord. Behold, a child shall be born unto the house of David, Josiah by name, and upon thee shall he offer the priests of the high places that burn incense upon thee, and then bone shall be burned up on thee. That was prophesied 325 years before Josiah was born. The other six who were named before they were born are Ishmael, Isaac, Solomon, Cyrus, John the Baptist, and Jesus. And people say that, see, I get my papers mixed up here, no telling where it will be. Okay, back to Plain Ashes Prophecy. Josiah acknowledged and became aware of the present day problems in the repairing of broken down kingdom values. This company will discover truths and injustices that need to be dealt with and present day truths that will become. This is a company of people that are aware of, pray into, and this is a company of prophets where you're aware of and pray into the everyday problems of the world as well as the everyday problems of those who are around us. Number three, this company will repent and humble themselves before God, but stand strong in wisdom and confidence of who God is and what he can do through their obedience. The prophetic word that came through me this morning is that you have become strong. Amen. As a corporate body, you have become strong.
Yes. Praise God.
Because of what God has brought us through.
Yes.
And what I guess he's going to take us through. This company will inquire of the Lord and not be afraid to apply the truth of their fathers and mothers of previous ages. If you've hung around this pasture very long, you know that I pull wisdom from people from 1600s or 1400s or 1300s that I'm not ashamed to say, hey, I quoted this from so-and-so. And this man still has the wisdom of God and it needs to be repeated. Yes. Some people have such big egos that they can't say just preach what God's told them, bless God. I need to know what these other people know. This company will value, honor, and appreciate the prophetic word of the Lord, making Amos 3:7 a standard of lifestyle and not just a trend. There are plenty of trendy churches doing trendy things.
Yeah.
The latest thing.
Yes.
The word of God in this church is a lifestyle.
Amen. Yes.
We don't care what the latest trend is.
No.
We gave that up a long time ago. The company will reconstitute the prophetic word of previous ages by prophesying present day truth into previous prophetic words. This company will value the currency of mercy to others, but fully engage the grace to deal with the lawlessness of the times. The action of obedience will deal with the spiritual chaos that has led to idolatry in the past. If you hang around here, you're going to hear pretty soon about the idolatry that's going on in this nation and people who are worshiping at it and being involved in it.
Yes.
This company will work a territorial strategy that understands their boundaries and measure of authority. He uses the word measure. They will rally the ecclesia within their territory and take a strong stand for righteousness, but be willing to go to battle with other territorial Josiah companies. They will do warfare to tear down and destroy the high places of iniquity, causing high-ranking demonic spirits to be bound and cast down. Yeah. You have been in this church long enough that you're not going around trembling and you're afraid of the devil.
Yes.
That you are afraid to take him on, because you might not have authority over him, or that he might take you out. Now, if you've got in you the devil, you don't have authority over him.
Right.
Whatever you've got in you that the devil, that you like the devil, what, you know, you like, you the only reason the devil's in there because you like him.
Yeah.
And those demons are in there because you're friendly with them.
Mm-hmm.
And you like to keep them. So if you're friendly with a demon and you like him hanging around, you don't have no authority over him.
Mm-hmm.
He'll beat you up. This company will restore authentic worship, which will no longer be just a service but a lifestyle, even manifesting as their reasonable service into the Lord at all times.
Amen.
Considering the 31-year reign of the Josiah Company begins next year. That's this year. Be strong, prevail. I also found that the words freedom and eagle are used 31 times in God's Word in the New Testament. The 31 times Jesus' name appears in Matthew 9:4 when he speaks of him as the Son of Man. 31st time Luke uses his name is in Luke 8:28, where he calls Jesus the Son of the Most High. I believe this means Jesus is revealing himself as the Son of Man and the Son of God in these beginning days of the new era. End of word posted by Clay Nash on the Elijah List last year. I had not read this until last night, prior to the Lord quickening to me about knowing him and presenting him to the people as the Son of Man. You've hung around me all these years. I have one message. I am taking you into the realm of the Spirit to know Jesus Christ in the glory of the Son of God. That is my message.
Yes.
To reveal to you, that's who I know him as, JT. I know this is how he has revealed himself to me, in his glory as the Son of God. But I realized last week, before I read this, that I really didn't know him as a son of man. Now, JJ, you're looking at me funny.
Yes, I am. I'm trying to get this started, you know, so I'm paying attention.
Yeah.
I want to hear that again.
I know you as a man. Mm-hmm. But when I look at you, JT, I look at your spirit, man. Mm-hmm. And I look at where you are on your journey into the glory of God. Mm-hmm. That's how I see you. Yes. With what these spiritual eyes that God has seen me.
Amen.
And I have a relationship with you. If you cry, I cry. If you laugh, I laugh. If you're happy, I'm happy. But Jesus Christ came to earth as a human.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He came to be part of humanity. He came to minister to our humanity.
Yes.
And as the Son of Man, he ministered to man's humanity. We can't just minister to the spirit of man. We've got to minister to their humanity.
Mm. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. True.
I'll get this worked out. Mm-hmm. 11:43. Okay. Daniel prophesied of the glory of Jesus Christ as the Son of Man. See, I see him because of the visions that God gave me early on of taking me into heaven and seeing him in heaven and seeing him in glory. My whole ministry has been to lead people into that. The glory of the Son of God, because that's what I see. Daniel prophesied of the glory of Jesus Christ, the Son of Man. I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. And there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion and shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed. Luke 21:27, Jesus says, then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. The sign of his second coming is the sign of the Son of Man.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he's asking us to come into a relationship with him that is more than we've experienced thus far.
Yes.
I don't know the way. Revelation 14:4. Then I looked and behold a white cloud, and on the cloud sat one like the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown and in his hand a sharp sickle. He shall come to us the second time, according to these words, as the Son of Man. I'll get it figured out. Unless y'all hang on.
Yeah. Something in the scripture it says, then I looked and behold a white cloud, and on the white cloud sat one like the Son of Man. That one word, like, what does that mean?
Well, that means that he's going to come to us like the Son of Man.
It looked like that. That's
really nice. Okay, but today, I'm closing up here. I don't like much. I'm all over the place, I know it. It's okay. Y'all keeping up?
Yes,
y'all keeping up?
Yes.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about King Josiah. Josiah. Son of Ammon, Ammon did evil as did Manasseh his father. We talked about that earlier. But the DNA of Josiah was from King David. Mm. That the prophet prophesied 325 years before.
Mm.
Many of the kings of Israel produced carbon copy sons who duplicated their father's evil ways. But God will continue to raise up his man for his time and for his sovereign work. This we know.
Yes.
If he sent a prophet, we don't even know the prophet's name, up to the altar of the Lord, the Spirit of God fell on that unknown prophet, and he prophesied to the altar of the Lord, and he said, God's going to have him a king, and his name's going to be Josiah, and he's going to do the work of the Lord. That is a sovereign act of God. Don't you know Satan tried to abort that baby?
Yes.
The underlying cause of the failure of human government is the lost consciousness of God.
Yes.
Without God, man is unable to successfully rule himself.
That's true.
Absolutely.
Look at our Congress. What a mess.
Yes.
A godless Congress for the most part, except there's got to be some godly people up there. And they're not successfully ruling anything.
No.
They're just up there making a big mess. It gets bigger every day.
They're afraid to speak publicly about their faith. They hide.
So if you're following me on the notes, we're going down to, as I've already used. In Josiah's eighth year of being king, now he would have been 16 years old, okay, he began to seek the Lord. And in the 12th year, at the age of 20, he began to purge Judah. And one of the notes I was looking at, from the age of 16 when he began to seek the Lord until he began to act on it at 20, it took him 4 years to purge himself. I heard groans and moans in here.
You can't have dominion over something you don't have dominion over yourself.
Right. You if you don't have dominion over it in here, you don't have dominion over anything. Josiah cut down the idols, broke them in pieces, and burned them. The purge went unto Ephraim, Manasseh, Simeon, and Naphtali. Josiah then returned to Jerusalem. It took him 6 years to destroy all the idols in these places.
Wow.
He went and did it himself, JT.
Yeah.
He didn't send somebody to do it. He went and did it. In Joe's 18th year, he was 26 years old. He sent 1, 2, 3 guys, Chapman, Mahasiah, Joah, to repair the house of the Lord. They delivered to Hilkiah, the high priest, the finances of the land to do this work. Hilkiah, the priest, found a book of the law of the Lord given by Moses. Y'all can follow me in 2 Kings 34. I'm in here. Hilkiah delivered the book to Shaphnah, the scribe, who carried it to King Josiah. Shaphnah read it before the king, who heard it and rent his clothes. Josiah then commanded Hilkiah, Ahikam, Mabdon, Shaphah, and Asaiah to inquire concerning the book, for they had not kept it to do all that was written. The company, after they read the book, they took it to Huldah the prophetess. She spoke that the Lord would bring the curses mentioned in the book because of Judah's idolatry. To Josiah came that word that because of his tenderness, humility, and repentance, his eyes would not see the judgment spoken. Now that is a word to our nation.
Yes.
Glory. Yes.
Because of what? Of the adultery. Because of the abortion. Because of the lack of the sacredness of marriage. Because of the homosexuality. Because of the killing of babies, because of all of these things that the government of America has sanctioned,
yeah,
we will come under judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But as long as there is a godly ruler, and as long as there are godly people on the land, perhaps we will not see it with our eyes.
Yes.
The full judgment.
Yes, I understand.
because of Josiah's mercy and goodness and tenderness and heart for the Lord held back the judgment until he was actually killed on the battlefield. That judgment did come. They repented. He purged the whole land. The Bible says he made them follow the word of the Lord. Yes. Says he made them stand. He forced them to do it.
Yes.
That could be a picture. The king gathered all the elders and the people to go up to the temple and read in all their ears all the words of the book of the covenant that was found. This is a picture of a pastor who stands in his or her place and reads and declares the words of the book.
Amen.
Yes. And you can read it in verse 34 too. He says he caused all that were present in Jerusalem to stand to it. I mean, they had to walk in it, they had to stand in it, and they had to become it. Now, that had to be an anointing that he carried, he caused. Because it'd be pretty head and hard to knock all those people in the head and make them. Yes, we need to pray. This, okay? This is what we're talking about. The King Josiah Company.
Yes.
The anointing of the King Josiah Company.
Yes.
You know, we don't get any of this other stuff done.
Yes.
Which hey, that's good. Let's go do it.
Stand in Jesus' name.
And we can make people stand in the word of God.
Amen.
Through our words and our lives and our speaking.
Yes.
That's the Josiah anointing. We need to be praying it. That would bring revival to this land.
Amen.
He caused all that were present in Jerusalem to stand to it. So, the prophet said that you're King Josiah Company.
Yes.
I receive it.
Yeah.
I receive it.
Yeah.
Amen.
God's sons will call the whole church to walk the word. He stood by a pillar when he did this.
Yeah.
Revelation 3:12. He who overcomes, I will make him a pillar in the temple of my God. And he shall go out no more. I will write on him the name of my God, and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem, which comes down out of heaven from my God. And I will write on him my new name. And this is not when Jesus comes again, though that will be. It is now for those who will overcome. Now.
Yeah.
Yes.
We can say that Josiah was a wrecking ball. Can we say he was a disruptor?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Kind of like someone else, you know.
Don't you know there had to be some politics in this thing? There had to be some political people saying, what's that boy think he's doing?
Mm-hmm.
Going out there tearing down all our altars, and we're making money off that.
Mm-hmm.
He's tearing everything up. He's making a terrible mess of everything.
He's just a snot-nosed kid.
Yeah, just Johnny Enlow, I think it's Johnny Enlow, that said that God is going to disrupt so much in this day that are ahead in us that he will have to do it in stages because it would be totally destructive if he did it all at one time. Josiah took away all the abominations and made all that were present in Israel to serve the Lord. Oh, we got a long way up. There's a whole lot to be done. All these days, but because we've only had this switch for we haven't even got 4 years yet.
Yeah.
It took Josiah 6 years to purge the land. And then,
drain the swamp.
Drain the swamp.
Yeah. So the file is taken by force.
Yes. All his days they did not depart from following the Lord, the God of their fathers. All his days. The basis of this cleansing was the reading of the word by the king.
That's good.
The idols in the temple of God were removed, burned in Kidron, and strung in Bethel. They put down the idolatrous priest who burned incense to all the planets. The Asherah was also removed from the temple, burned at Kidron, and stamped to powder. Josiah broke down the house of the Sodomites. Male prostitutes.
Yes.
I said this 20-year-old, 26-year-old boy.
He got busy. he got busy.
And we need this anointing, y'all. We need this spiritual anointing, and we need to go after these things like when you have the authority. Right, Deborah?
Yes.
Amen? You follow it? You track it here? Because you got some authority in your house, woman. You got some authority over evil.
That's right.
You need to stand up.
That's right.
He did, the word they in the Bible is defiled, but he really destroyed all the high places of Judah. Now I want y'all to hear this, because I believe this is a strategy. He destroyed Topaz, which is in the valley of Hinnom. And this is the place where they did human sacrifices to Molech.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so see, we the church, we have bound up the spirit of Molech. We come against the spirit of Molech, not the sacrifice of babies. But there is a strong man, a stronghold called Topaz, which is in the valley of Hinnom. That's a power principality over a region. We need to bring down the power principality over Molech.
Amen.
And Baal. But in this particular verse, Topaz, which is in the valley of Hinnom, was the place where they did the human sacrifices. He took away the horses offered to the sun and burned the chariots of the sun with fire. This is a counterfeit Elijah ministry that he tore down. Chariots of fire. Called chariots of the sun. Josiah destroyed the upper chamber of Ahaz and the altars of Manasseh. Now listen to this, 2 Kings 23:13. Then the king destroyed the high places that were east of Jerusalem, which were on the south of the Mount of Corruption.
It sounds like the Holy Spirit came back in. I mean, he's full of the Holy Spirit, huh?
Mount of Corruption.
It's like, this guy, he was like.
We have a Mount of Corruption in Washington, D.C. It was Clay Nash. Prophesied to Lori and Pete Fajardo, Pastor Fajardo. That Sydney, Texas is a place that is totally corrupt. And full of corrupt leadership, right there in front of God and everybody, he said this. He said it's totally corrupt. He went on and on about it. He named off different places. Where Sissom, Texas. Did y'all hear this? Am I the only one that heard this?
Yeah.
Okay, Sissom, Texas is totally corrupt. Tell Lori, she's tired anyway. Tell her to go get steaks. And put on there the word of the Lord and put stakes all around, put it in around Sissom, Texas to break off that spirit of corruption. The Bible calls it a mountain of corruption. Aren't y'all glad y'all came today?
Yeah.
We need to go to Washington, D.C. and put some stakes around that mountain. Which Solomon, king of Israel, had built for Ashtaroth, the abomination of the Sidonians.
Solomon built the mount of corruption. I've always stood up for him. I've always stood up for Solomon. People talk about whether he got to heaven or not. Because
yes.
I always felt like he did. But he lost his crown. For Chemosh, the abomination of the Moabites, and for Milcom, the abomination of the people of Ammon. All the above is operating in our nation and the churches. Proverbs 20:26. A wise king scatters the wicked and brings the wheel over them. We need to be praying for our president to not only scatter the wicked, but to bring the wheel over them. King before or after, like Josiah, who had turned the Lord with his whole heart, soul, and mind. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he said.
Mm-hmm. So the prophet said, "You are a King Josiah company."
He could have done this in the law with him. You know, it's so baffling to me to think about how bold he was. You know, and then the Holy Spirit did come and tell the book of Acts, but this guy here is acting like he got all of it. And some, you know? So that's amazing to me.
So now we know what the King Josiah Company does. I think we got this right. I think this has got your name on it.
No, wait.
What?
Cause?
Things don't matter.
Things don't matter. It gets matter.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And a lot of this stuff is good stuff.